important issues. Could I now call, leading for the opposition, Senator Michael McDougall?
It was my intention to draw the attention of the House today to the motion in my name and that of other senators, including senators from all groups and parties in this House, in relation to, which is number 8 on the order paper, in relation to the fate of Richard O'Halloran, who is being detained in China at the moment. Last week, the Minister for Foreign Affairs and Trade, Simon Coveney, called me about this motion and requested me, because he stated that the matter was at a delicate stage of negotiation, not to have the House debate this matter in case it might set that process back. And I regard any request of that kind by a minister very seriously and not one to be lightly disregarded. I've been involved in attempting to have Mr. O'Halloran's fate and the cruel treatment of him dealt with since last year. I told the minister that I would consult Mr. O'Halloran's family on his request, and that he could help by indicating the detail of what steps his department was taking. Now, years ago, the former Secretary to the Government, Padraig O'Higgins, said to me that, somewhat cynically, I suppose, he said that there were three stages for Ivy House in any matter: the stage at which it was premature to do anything, the stage at which it was too sensitive, and the stage at which it was too late. And I'm just saying now, in relation to that, I am giving the benefit of the doubt to that department in not having the House debate this matter today. But I do want to emphasise, and I circulated to all members of the House today, an article by Justine McCarthy in the Sunday Times outlining the great suffering to him and his family. No Chinese citizen would be treated in this way in this country. And the comparative size of our two countries doesn't justify wolf diplomacy being deployed against Ireland to try and blackmail this man into doing something unlawful. And I also want to make this point, that the Department of Foreign Affairs has been renamed the Department of Foreign Affairs and Trade. But we cannot trade the rights of an Irish citizen to have full representation by this state to vindicate his rights and to secure his freedom. And no question of Irish exports to China, or how they would deal this way or that, or whether the Chinese government would be offended by anything that's said in this House, should colour our treatment of this matter. The time has come for this House to speak on this issue, and I'm affording a 2-week opportunity to the Minister to produce results in this matter. And I intend, in 2 weeks' time, to move an order of business amendment to have this all-party motion fully debated if the Chinese government and the Department of Foreign Affairs and Trade have not secured Mr. O'Halloran's release in the meantime. Thank you, Cairdig.
Motion number 8 on the order paper was spoken so passionately and, I suppose, so caringly about by Minister McDougall. I will absolutely have no issue in debating or scheduling a debate in the next number of weeks, if you so wish. I think you would have unanimous support in this House, in any House in Ireland, for the absolute safe return of Richard O'Halloran to his wife and his three children. I can't begin to imagine the difficulty that they have gone through in the last number of years, both himself being isolated in a faraway country and his three children and his wife being left here isolated in their own home county or country. We need to do absolutely everything that we can to make sure that we get him home. And I genuinely would have enormous trust and I suppose a positive outlook on Simon Coveney and his team's actions at the moment, and hopefully there will be a positive outcome before there is a need. But there's no problem at all in us having a debate if that's where we find ourselves in a number of weeks. And just very finally.